Very good afternoon. You're watching the Midday News on Rajya Sabha Television this Saturday afternoon. I'm Ashwara Kapoor. Let us start with the Midday News with the top headlines. Air India restores a software glitch after 6 hours of trouble. Flight delays leave hundreds of passengers stranded at airports globally. Airline regrets inconvenience, says ripple effect may be felt all day today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addresses public rally in Kannauj in Uttar Pradesh, says he wants to take country forward in all sectors, accuses Congress, SP and BSP of playing caste-based politics. Prime Minister to also hold a Vijay Sankalp rally in Sitapur. Campaigning to end for fourth phase of polls this evening, voting for 71 seats in 9 states on 29th of April. Giriraj Singh, Subhash Bhamre, Babul Supriyo, Dimple Yadav, Munmun Sen, Priya Dutt in the fray. Campaigning to also close for the fourth and final phase of Odisha Assembly elections. BJP Chief Amit Shah leads BJP's campaign in Jharkhand and Odisha, holds public rally in Jharkhand's Palamu, Rahul Gandhi to hold rallies in Rai Bareli and Amethi, Priyanka Gandhi Vadra in Barabanki and Unnao. BJD, SP and BSP step up electioneering in the state. And shooter Abhishek Verma clinches gold medal in 10 meters air pistol in Beijing, seals the fifth quota bench for India at the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. The top story this afternoon, Air India operations were affected globally this morning due to a technical problem in the airline's main server. Now, the system has been restored. The shutdown of the check-in software left hundreds of Air India passengers stranded at several airports across the country. 85 Air India flights were delayed in the morning. 18 domestic flights have been rescheduled so far. The software did not function properly for almost 6 hours from 3 a.m. to 9 a.m. on Saturday. Due to this, a boarding pass could not be issued at major airports across the world and various flights were delayed. Now, Sita, the company which is responsible for the software, is looking into the root cause of the glitch. And Ashwini Lohani, Chairman and Managing Director of Air India, said that the ripple effect of the glitch might be felt throughout the day today.
Passenger services system hai, jo reservations, check-in aur baggage ko control karta hai, usko maintenance ke liye liya gaya tha, savere 3:30 se 4:30. ये सीता का सिस्टम है, सीता एक इंटरनेशनल कंपनी, उनका सिस्टम है, उसके मेंटेनेंस के लिए लिया गया था, बिकॉज उसमें फ़्लाइट्स नहीं होती हैं करीब 3:30-4:30 के बीच में, बट उसके बाद वो लाइव नहीं आ पाया क्योंकि उसमें कुछ टेक्निकल ग्लिचेस हो गए थे. ये बंद रहा करीब 8:45 तक, 8:45 पे लाइव में वापस आया है सिस्टम. और इस बीच पूरे जितने टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट्स हैं वो सब लगे रहे इसमें टेक्निकल ग्लिच ढूंढने के लिए. सॉफ्टवेयर वाला सिस्टम है तो सॉफ्टवेयर में कई कई प्रॉब्लम्स आती हैं. सीता की टीम अटलांटा में लगी रही इसमें. 8:45 पे सिस्टम ठीक हुआ और करीब 10 बजे तक 85 फ्लाइट्स डिले हुई हैं इस सिस्टम की वजह से. और क्योंकि सवेरे की जो 85 फ्लाइट्स डिले हुई हैं इसकी वजह से इसका रिपल इफेक्ट चलता रहेगा दिन भर. दिन में और फ्लाइट्स भी डिले होंगी. आज मैं हमने कुछ फ्लाइट्स को तो रीशेड्यूल किया है. इंटरनेशनल डिपार्चर्स जो दिन में जाने हैं उनमें कोई विशेष दिक्कत नहीं है. एक दो फ्लाइट्स में डिले है. शंघाई की फ़्लाइट हमारी करीब 1.5 घंटा डिले हो रही है. बाकी जो यूरोप का बैंक है वो करीब करीब टाइम पर जा रहा है. कुछ फ्लाइट्स हो सकता है 15 मिनट आधा घंटा डिले हो. पर डोमेस्टिक फ़्लाइट्स को हमने अभी इमीडिएटली 18 फ्लाइट्स को रीशेड्यूल किया है. बट इम्पैक्ट इसका रहेगा दिन भर और इससे जो यात्रियों को जो असुविधा हुई है उसके लिए हम लोग को बहुत ज़्यादा खेद है. तो यात्रियों को हमने, जिनकी फ़्लाइट्स मिस हो जाएंगी उनको हम होटल अकोमोडेशन देंगे, उनको दूसरे कैरियर्स में या अपनी किसी और फ़्लाइट में रीशेड्यूल किया जाएगा. सब रीशेड्यूल के चार्जेस और वेवर्स के चार्जेस इन सबको वेव ऑफ कर दिया गया है. टी स्नैक्स का हमने प्रबंध किया है. होटल स्टे का प्रबंध किया है.
And now let's all get you the election related news. Electioneering for the fourth phase of Lok Sabha elections will close this evening. 71 seats across 9 states will go to polls in the fourth phase on 29th of April. Over 12 crore 79 lakh voters will exercise their franchise in this phase. 945 candidates are in the fray in the fourth phase. Over 140,000 polling stations have been set up. And speaking about the states that are going to polls on 29th, 17 seats in Maharashtra, 13 seats each in Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, 6 seats each in Odisha and Madhya Pradesh, 8 seats in West Bengal, 5 seats in Bihar, 3 seats in Jharkhand, 1 seat in Jammu and Kashmir will go to polls on 29th of April. And prominent names in the fray in this phase are Union Minister Giriraj Singh from Begusarai in Bihar, Dimple Yadav from Uttar Pradesh's Kannauj, former Cabinet Minister Shri Prakash Jaiswal is contesting from Kanpur, and from West Bengal's Asansol seat, TMC candidate Munmun Sen is fighting against BJP's Babul Supriyo. And Odisha will also witness the last and the final phase of voting on 41 assembly seats on 29th of April, and campaigning for the assembly election also will end today evening in the state. So indeed, electioneering is reaching a crescendo on the last day of campaigning today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed a poll rally in Kannauj in Uttar Pradesh, terming opposition alliance as opportunist. Prime Minister Modi accused the Congress, SP and BSP of indulging in caste politics. He also slammed BSP chief Mayawati for seeking support of a Samajwadi party just for the sake of power. In Kannauj, the contest is between BJP's Subrata Pathak and SP's Dimple Yadav. Kannauj, remember, will vote in the fourth phase on 29th of April.
इससे कैसे निपटेंगे? सपा बसपा के पास कोई फॉर्मूला है क्या? सपा बसपा के लोग इस पूरे चुनाव में एक बार भी आतंकवाद बोले हैं? मोदी को 100 गाली दी, आतंकवाद के खिलाफ 10 गाली बोले हैं क्या? आज मोदी का प्रचार वो परिवार कर रहा है जिसके बेटे मातृभूमि की रक्षा के लिए खड़े हैं, जिन्हें बुलेट प्रूफ की जरूरत थी मोदी ने पहुंचा दिया, जिसे हथियार की जरूरत थी मोदी ने पहुंचा दिया, उस जवान बेटे के मां बाप मोदी के लिए दुआ मांग रहे हैं। आज सभी एक मत होकर कह रहे हैं कि महामिलावटी लोगों, सारी कोशिश कर लो लेकिन आएगा तो।
And later in the day, Prime Minister Modi will campaign in Hardoi and in Sitapur. Hardoi, remember, is going to polls on 29th of April in the fourth phase, while Sitapur will vote in the fifth phase. And BJP President Amit Shah held a public rally in Jharkhand's Palamu today, accusing the Congress party of not being able to eradicate poverty. Amit Shah said that only Narendra Modi government has taken concrete steps towards this and decided to provide basic amenities such as electricity, toilets, gas cylinders and drinking water to every household in the country by 2022. In the rally, Amit Shah also hit out at all the leaders of the Grand Alliance, saying that Akhilesh Yadav, Mayawati, Chandrababu Naidu would take turns at being the Prime Minister of the Alliance government in the absence of a concrete face.
मित्रों, नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने तय किया है कि 2022 में जब देश के आजादी के 75 साल समाप्त हो गए, 2022 के अंदर इस देश में एक भी घर ऐसा नहीं होगा, एक भी घर ऐसा नहीं होगा जहां बिजली नहीं होगी, शौचालय नहीं होगा, गैस का चूल्हा नहीं होगा और पीने का पानी भी नहीं। इस सारी सुविधाएं 2022 तक हर गरीब के घर में पहुंचाने का निर्णय नरेंद्र मोदी सरकार ने।
And the opposition too has stepped up its campaign. Congress President Rahul Gandhi will address rallies in Rai Bareli and Amethi, while Party General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi Vadra will hold road show and public meetings in Barabanki and in Unnao. And our colleague Akhilesh Suman is now joining us live from Munger in Bihar. Akhilesh, now 66 candidates are in the fray for the five constituencies, Darbhanga, Samastipur, Begusarai, of course, Munger and Ujjapur that are going to polls in the fourth phase of the election. Tell us about the key characteristics of these five constituencies and what are the key issues for the electorate here.
You know, one of the major characteristics of all the four-phase election is that all the five seats belong to NDA. And you know that in the last 2014 election, JDU was not the part of NDA. But now BJP, JDU and LJP are part major parts of NDA in this area. And in that way, you can see that there is a bit of churning. Maybe NDA is feeling that they are stronger because of JDU joining the camp. Also because JDU is in the power here. Nitish Kumar is the chief minister. So I think some of the people are feeling that, you know, that the question of nationalism, the question of how development thrown by Narendra Modi might be one of the major issues. But on the other side also, you can see that in some of the areas, you know, opposition is also putting very strong candidate. Like in, if you see in, you know, Ujjapur, Upendra Kushwaha is there, who was the cabinet minister earlier, but now he is in Grand Alliance Forte. And he is fighting against Nityananda Rai, of president of BJP in the state. Other than that, if you go to Nalanda, you know, Darbhanga is the sitting seat of BJP, and now BJP is in strong battle against the Grand Alliance. In Samastipur, Ramchandra Paswan, the brother of Ram Vilas Paswan, is fighting election. And in 2014, he had won just by 7,000 vote margin. So in this election, he is expecting that once JDU has joined the camp, he might get better. But Congress on the other side is trying to think that if 7,000 is the margin, they can also get, because now they are strongly with the RJD. And they are campaigning in the basis of, Karpuri Thakur, Lalu Prasad Yadav, and also telling businessmen that once we are in the power, we will, abolish all the system of approval for the business.
Yes.
So in that way, Congress is also putting very strong face.
Mm-hmm.
In Munger, where I am standing here,
yes.
In Munger, Lalan Singh is the JDU candidate. He is considered to be the right-hand man of Nitish Kumar, and he is feeling that once BJP is there with him, he can win. Because in the last election, he has been defeated by none other than LJP. Now LJP is the ally. But he is confronting with, Anand Singh's wife, Neelam Devi, and Anand Singh is considered to be a strong man, muscle man of this area.
Right.
And he was in JDU earlier, but now he is in Grand Alliance Congress ticket. But people say that Anand Singh keeps close touch with people in the area, and that is his major point.
All right.
You know that in this election, local issues are also cropping up. Some people are telling about, lack of municipal facilities. You know, water is a very scarce thing is here. Medical facilities are not here.
Yes.
They have to go to Patna if there is a, very severe disease.
Right.
They are asking for a good institutional educational institution, given the fact that Munger had been one of the major centers of Bihar in the independence movement.
So
local issues are there, national issues are there, personality cult is there. So it will be very interesting election in this phase, fourth phase, Aishwarya.
Absolutely, very interesting phase of election in this fourth phase. Akhilesh, thank you so much for joining us from Bihar. And we now go across to Kanpur, where Navikram Singh is joining us live. A very good afternoon, Navikram. Speaking about The Uttar Pradesh election in the fourth phase, of course, as the election juggernaut is going now rolling down to the central and the Bundelkhand region of Uttar Pradesh. Of course, it is going to be very personality specific because, you know, we are seeing a number of political heavyweights are in the fray, especially in this phase. We talk about Dimple Yadav, of course, Sri Prakash Jaiswal is there. We have Sakshi Maharaj and Jitin Prasad, all the political heavyweights are there. So this is going to be a very interesting phase.
बिल्कुल, ये चरण क्योंकि पिछले चरण के मुकाबले सबसे ज़्यादा सीटें हैं, 13 सीटों पर चुनाव होना है, तो ये चरण बेहद दिलचस्प है क्योंकि इस चरण में पूरी तरीके से त्रिकोणीय मुकाबला हम लोगों को होता दिख रहा है क्योंकि कांग्रेस भी यहाँ पर कई सीटों पर मजबूत है। महागठबंधन जो बनाने की कवायद की गई समाजवादी पार्टी, बसपा और RLD की तरफ से, वो भी यहाँ पर पूरा जोर लगा रहे हैं। ऐश्वर्या, ये जो इलाका है, यहाँ पर काशी राम हो या राम मनोहर लोहिया हो, उनकी कर्मभूमि है। मुलायम सिंह यादव जैसे नेता की ये जन्मस्थली है इटावा के आसपास, तो पूरा ये इलाका पूरे सभी राजनीतिक दलों ने पूरे प्रचार में ताकत झोंक दी है यहाँ पर। लेकिन दिलचस्प ये है ऐश्वर्या, जिस तरीके से अगर हम झांसी की बात करें तो झांसी में एक सभी पार्टियों ने नए चेहरे को तरजीह दी है। BJP की तरफ से उमा भारती की जगह अब दूसरे नेता अनुराग शर्मा मैदान में है, पहली बार चुनाव लड़ रहे हैं। इसी तरीके से चंद्रपाल यादव समाजवादी पार्टी के बड़े नेता माने जाते हैं बुंदेलखंड के, लेकिन झांसी से उनका टिकट उनकी जगह किसी और को उतारा गया है। और कांग्रेस में प्रदीप जैन आदित्य जो पूर्व केंद्रीय मंत्री थे उनका भी टिकट काट दिया गया है, तो नए चेहरे। इसी तरीके से भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने कानपुर में भी यहाँ पर सत्यदेव पचौरी को टिकट दिया है। मुरली मनोहर जोशी यहाँ से पिछली बार सांसद थे, बड़े अंतर से जीत दर्ज की थी। तो लेकिन यहाँ पर शिल्पिका जायसवाल जो तीन बार यहाँ से लगातार जीत चुके हैं वो मैदान में हैं कांग्रेस की तरफ से, तो यहाँ पर मुकाबला थोड़ा दिलचस्प होता दिखाई दे रहा है। लेकिन महागठबंधन के सामने जो सबसे बड़ी चुनौती आ रही है वो उनके भीतर ही जो अंतर विरोध है, कार्यकर्ताओं तक अपनी बात को पहुँचाना एक बड़ी चुनौती साबित हो रही है। साथ ही अगर BSP की बात करें ऐश्वर्या, BSP में अब जिस तरीके से पहले बड़े नेता नसीमुद्दीन सिद्दीकी या ब्रजेश पाठक जैसे नेता हुआ करते थे जो BSP को बहुत मजबूत बनाते थे, उस तरीके के नेता नहीं है। इसी तरीके से समाजवादी पार्टी में शिवपाल यादव एक कद्दावर नेता हुआ करते थे, बाकी वो अपने समर्थकों के साथ अलग हैं। तो महागठबंधन समाजवादी पार्टी और बहुजन समाजवादी पार्टी के अगर पुराने रिकॉर्ड को देखें तो बहुत मजबूत नजर आते हैं, लेकिन जो भीतर अंतर्विरोध है वो एक बड़ी चुनौती है महागठबंधन के सामने। उसका फायदा हमने पहले चरण से देखा लगातार, पहले चरण दूसरे चरण के बाद अब तक उसका फायदा कहीं ना कहीं BJP को मिलता हुआ दिखाई दे रहा
जी,
है।
बिल्कुल, नविक्रम देखना होगा, देखना होगा कि किस तरह से फाइट हम देखेंगे चौथे चरण में भी, जब ये मुकाबला अब बुंदेलखंड और सेंट्रल उत्तर प्रदेश की तरफ जाता है। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका हमसे बात करने के लिए, धन्यवाद। एंड राइट नाउ वी आर जॉइंड इन बाय कृति मिश्रा हु इज joining us from Jabalpur in Madhya Pradesh. Speaking about Madhya Pradesh, Kriti, of course, BJP had won all but two seats in Madhya Pradesh in 2014. But the way Congress party performed in the assembly elections, it has given a positivity and it has sensed an opportunity here to win election in this Lok Sabha election. What is the mood that you are able to capture on the last day of electioneering today here?
Well, Ashwarya, on 29th of April, six seats in Madhya Pradesh would go for polls in the first phase in Madhya Pradesh particularly, along with the four phases in the country of Lok Sabha elections. Remember, Madhya Pradesh is considered the nursery of the BJP. It is the cradle of the BJP. There have been almost 14 seats since the last 15 years that the BJP hasn't lost. The BJP had ruled the roost here for the last 15 years. Of course, it was a cliffhanger during the assembly elections where the Congress, despite getting lower vote share, was able to garner more seats and was able to form the government. So certainly the Congress party is emboldened. But the BJP is absolutely confident, saying that parliamentary elections are different from the assembly elections, and is riding high on Prime Minister Modi's charisma and all the central sector schemes. And of course, the BJP claims that the kind of work that the BJP government did in the state, that would also propel it to power and will help it gain more seats in the Lok Sabha elections. The Congress party is riding high on the crop loan waiver that it has given to the farmers. It claims that more than 2 lakh farmers have been benefited. But remember, the BJP has been upping the ante against the Congress on this particular scheme, with Prime Minister yesterday upping the ante on the Congress, saying that it was a sham. So certainly both sides are very confident right now, and it's a close contest, many are saying, in these 6 seats. Because remember, in the 2014, out of these 6 seats, the BJP won 5 and the Congress could only retain 1 seat, that was Chindwara. So it's an interesting contest, and 29th, the people of Madhya Pradesh in this first phase in Madhya Pradesh would decide the fate of the candidates. Aishwarya?
All right. Thank you so much, Kriti, for all those updates there from Madhya Pradesh. Of course, all the 6 seats that are going to election in this phase are interesting, but of course what happens in Chindwara would be particularly interesting. Thank you so much, Kriti, for all those updates. All right, let's get to some other news. At least 15 people were killed when suicide bombers blew themselves up during a shootout with the security forces in Sri Lanka's eastern province. The dead include 6 children and 3 women. 4 suspected suicide bombers have been killed. 3 others are injured and are in the hospital. Police, special task force personnel and the army troops were engaged in the gun battle with the armed group at a house in the Kalanumai city. The heavily armed men opened fire on the troops, leading to the shootout on Friday night, and a civilian who was also caught in the gun battle died. The police said that the curfew imposed in the Muslim-majority areas would continue until further notice. The police also said that 20 more people were arrested in connection with the 21st of April bombings. And the United States has imposed sanctions on Pakistan after Islamabad refused to take back its citizen deportees and visa overstayers from America. The U.S. warned that it may withhold visas of Pakistanis beginning from its senior officials. Now, Pakistan is the latest to join the list of 10 nations that have been imposed with sanctions under a U.S. law. The Trump administration, after coming to power, had said that it will strictly enforce such provisions by denying visas to people from those countries that refuse to accept deportees and visa overstayers. And in more news from the United States, President Donald Trump announced on Friday that his administration is withdrawing the U.S. signature from the U.N. Arms Trade Treaty, or the ATT. Donald Trump told an audience at the National Rifle Association's annual meeting in Indianapolis that his action was in response to the concerns from gun rights activists that it could impinge on the Americans' rights to bear arms. Former President Barack Obama had signed the treaty in 2013 and sent the treaty to the Senate for ratification. And on stage on Friday, Donald Trump signed a notice to the Senate asking it to stop the ratification process and return the treaty to the White House, where I will dispose of it, he said. Now, the treaty seeks to regulate international trade in conventional arms, including everything from tanks to small arms, specifically looking to prevent and eradicate illicit trade in conventional arms and prevent their diversion. Sports news now. Abhishek Verma's gold at the ISSF World Cup in the 10-meter air pistol event on Saturday has earned India its 5th quota place at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. He won the gold in the 10-meter air pistol event after shooting a score of 242.7 in the final at the Beijing World Cup. Now, this is Abhishek Verma's first medal at the World Cup. For India, it is their 4th medal at this World Cup. Earlier, Manu Bhakar and Saurabh Chaudhary had also won a gold in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team event, while Divyan Singh Panwar had won the silver medal in the men's 10-meter air rifle event and gold in the 10-meter air rifle mixed team event with Anjum Mudgil. And that is the wrap on this edition of Midday News. Thanks for watching.